flying. It's one of the most horrifying forms of common travel. You can't hide from the fact that you're just in a giant metal bus hurtling through the air, using nothing but the laws of thermodynamics and hopes and dreams. It's 2023, and we're constantly researching and developing new ways to improve the safety and quality of our life. We have robots automating dangerous factory work, and self-driving cars are on the horizon in a bid to fix the mistake we made by letting humans drive cars in the first place. It made me wonder, can I make planes fly themselves? Because that sounds a bit less scary, doesn't it? To try and answer this question, I first had to create the environment. So I experimented with Blender and made some simple assets, the map for the game, some rocks and some checkpoints. Finally, just get the circuit right. Yep, that's perfect. I was gonna spend some time trying to make a plane in Blender, but I found this pretty sick says that on the Unity asset store for $5 and just said, fuck it. Once I imported all of the assets, I just spent a little bit of time setting the scene up so things look nice, and I stole a trick from every game developer that's ever lived. You see, you can make a couple of the same assets and just keep rescaling and reorienting it to make it look like you have a more diverse scene. After I got the rough setup done, it's finally time to write some code. Now, I wanted my propeller to become a spinny bitch, and quite fittingly, my co-pilot came in handy for this one because it actually understands what a quaternion is. All right, so we're spinning, not quite the way we want it to be. Let's try that one again. All right, a little bit closer. Okay, now let's just speed this shit up a little bit. Let's go! We're moving, baby! I quickly coded up a script just so we can add controls for the airplane, slap that onto a naughty little Cessna, and we have life. Wait, that's not right. Let's fix that. The idea for the training environment here is to have a circuit of checkpoints that the agents have to fly through. I'm using PPO again for this one, with a bunch of agents in the same scene to train simultaneously. Now you might be wondering, how can a plane fly by itself if it can't see anything? Bunch of fucking lasers. Using raycasts, we shoot a bunch of lasers in front, above and below us. And when the laser collides with an object, we know the exact location of that object in relation to a plane. The agent has 9 explicit observations: its own velocity, the direction to the next checkpoint, and the direction that the checkpoint is facing. These are all 3-dimensional vectors with an X, a Y, and a Z coordinate. With PPO, we have to define the size of the brain before we start training. Our agent can choose 2 of 6 actions per step: pitch up, don't pitch, pitch down, turn left, don't turn, and turn right. Since we have 9 explicit observations and 24 total rays cast per plane, that gives us 33 input neurons, 2 hidden layers with 256 units each, and 6 output neurons for a total of 551 neurons in our agent's brain. When the agent flies through a checkpoint, it gets a reward. To speed up the initial training process, I gave the agent a small positive reward every time it flies towards the next checkpoint to encourage it to move in that direction. If the agent takes too long to get to a checkpoint, or it crashes, then is punished and the episode is reset. This lets it fail early and fail often. To encourage the agent to finish the course as quickly as possible, I gave the agent a small punishment for every single step that is taken. This means that for the agent, it literally hurts to exist, so it needs to rush towards that next hit of sweet, sweet dopamine in order to just bring a little bit of joy into his otherwise miserable life. If you're wondering what a reward and punishment is in the scope of reinforcement learning, they're just numbers. Machines fucking love numbers. Seriously, my training environment is like a giant source of computer crack. It gives Adelaide a run for his money. Now that a plane's flying, let's make things a little bit more interesting. Added some textures to the environment, a moat around the circuit, and a waterfall just for the aesthetic. I finished up the script for the agent, and now we can start training. So the very first thing the agents learned to do was either fly straight towards the ceiling, or straight out of the map to avoid the punishment of death. So I added a transparent box around the map so that there's no escaping the inevitable. I don't have any negative impact for agent on agent collision yet, other than they can bounce each other into walls, but they learn surprisingly quickly considering that I could barely fly around the course myself. After letting them train for a while, we've got a pretty good end product. It's one of the most satisfying things you can watch. Have a look at this. It might be important to know that I haven't actually given the agents any instructions yet for what to do after it reaches the finish line. Currently, they're just flying straight up into the air as soon as they reach it, in order to reduce the total amount of time they spent on the map. Remember the painful existence thing? If you like this video, check out this one here where I trained AI to play 3D Pong.